Have you always wanted a garden but didn't know where to start? Nursery Life, your gardening BFF, is here for you. Hello everyone, I'm Swati, and in association with Nursery Life, I will help you create your home garden through this video series on indoor plants. So today I'm going to talk about top 10 house plants that thrive during monsoon, during the rainy season. Few of them can be kept indoors and few will produce lots many flowers if you keep them in a sunny balcony. They are very easy to grow, even beginners in gardening can grow them. Few plants have been sent to me by Nursery Life. If you haven't heard about them, let me help you. They deliver all kind of plants and all gardening related products across India and will also offer all the guidance related to plants care. Also, you can buy these kind of attractive plastic pots from their websites, which are available in different colors and sizes. Before we begin, do not forget to click on the subscribe button next to the Nursery Life channel. Together, let's create a healthy and happy garden. Alright, let's talk about our first plant from the list, which is Calathea. There are many species in Calathea plant family with different color, texture, shape of leaves. And the one I'm holding is Calathea zebrina. I totally love the texture and the color of this leaf. They grow profusely during a monsoon season, which is June till September, which is the rainy season. You'll see lots many new leaves during this season. They grow fantastically in monsoon season, and if your pot is full, you can easily divide them through root division method and you can make multiple plants out of one pot. They love bright and indirect sunlight. Keep it somewhere where it gets filtered sunlight or bright light, but no direct sunlight. You don't need to water it daily. Water it only when the top layer of the soil feels dry. If we talk about fertilizing them, fertilize it during their growing season, which is the rainy season. Fertilize it once in a month, that too something which has more of nitrogen. So fertilize them with nitrogen rich fertilizer for its beautiful and big foliage. And this plant blooms in orange color. Yes, they bloom flowers. They are mainly grown for their beautiful foliage, but they produce flowers also. One of the beautiful indoor plant for interior decoration. You can keep them anywhere in your living room and they will, you know, give a jazzy look to your interiors. Our next plant is philodendron, one of the most popular, drought tolerant, very durable air purifier indoor plant with very low maintenance. And the one I'm showing is lemon lime, philodendron lemon lime plant. It has lots many varieties with various leaves, sizes, shapes and colors. The one I'm showing is a climber one. It's an ornamental plant and this is a perfect air purifier plant. It removes formaldehyde and benzene along with other toxins from atmosphere. It can be grown in very low light conditions as well. Even you can grow them in artificial bright light. Very easy to grow from cuttings. Even you can grow them in water, like money plants or pothos. During this season, you will see lots many new leaves coming up, and this will grow fantastically in monsoon season. When we talk about its fertilizers, fertilize it once in their growing season, which is monsoon. Fertilize them again with nitrogen-rich fertilizer for their lush, green, big foliage. Don't keep this plant in direct sunlight, otherwise their leaves will get burnt. You don't need to water it every other day. It's a very drought-tolerant plant and very easy to grow and maintain. A highly recommended plant for those who are beginners in gardening. Our third plant is fiddle leaf ficus, another amazing air purifier plant, very easy to grow and a classy plant for interior look. This plant is very much in trend these days for interior decoration. This plant loves filtered sunlight and it is perfect to be kept indoors somewhere near your windows. It can be easily grown from stem cuttings. During monsoon, you will see lots many leaves coming up and your plant will look even more happier in rainy season. When we talk about their fertilizer requirements, they love nitrogen-rich fertilizers because if you want big foliage, much more green and fresh looking leaves, then you need to put more of nitrogen-rich fertilizer. That too in their growing season, once in a month. Check the soil before watering it. Just poke your finger into the soil and if you find it dry, only then water it. Another very easy to grow and maintain plant, especially for beginners in gardening. Our next plant that thrives during monsoon is ferns. There are lots many varieties in ferns, but one of the most popular one is Boston fern. This is another air purifier plant with attractive foliage. This is an ideal plant for hanging baskets and they thrive during monsoons or the rainy season. You'll see lots many new leaves coming up and the plant will get full and dense. Your pot will look full. Very easy to grow from root division method. You can easily separate the plant from their roots and grow them in many pots. Very easy to grow in almost any kind of soil and it's a very low maintenance plant. Loves lots and lots of water. Keep it somewhere it gets filtered sunlight. If you'll keep it in direct sunlight, the leaves will get burnt. Our next plant is Anthurium. This is an amazing indoor flowering plant, another air purifier plant recommended by NASA. Very low maintenance plant. The plant loves bright but indirect sunlight. Don't keep the plant in direct sunlight, otherwise the flowers and the leaves will get burnt. And when we talk about its soil, the plant loves well-drained soil. The water should not get stagnant into the pot and you can see the plant thriving and it can be grown by the root division method. When you see the plant has become full, the pot has become full, you can divide it from the root portion and replicate them in other pots. Very easy to grow and maintain. If we talk about their flowers, these red colors, heart shape, these are its flowers. They come in white color, pink color and red color. This comes in three colors. You can grow them in artificial sunlight as well. The plant goes in dormancy during winters. If we talk about its water requirements, don't overwater it. Always check the soil before watering it. Avoid watering on flowers and leaves as it may cause fungus to the plant. Very easy to grow plant. Keep it in your bedroom near windows or in your living room and they will bloom profusely. Their growing season is February till September. They bloom heavily during monsoon. Now if we talk about flowering plants that bloom heavily during this season, if they are kept in a sunny balcony or if they are grown in full sunlight, then the first name that comes in my mind is Portulaca, which is also known as moss rose, purslane or 9 o'clock, because they bloom in the morning around 9 o'clock. They come in many colors, red, pink, bright pink, shaded ones, white, orange, many more colors. This is one of the easiest plant to grow from their cuttings. Just take the cutting and grow them in any kind of soil. They are very much drought tolerant. You don't need to water them every day. They bloom heavily during summers and monsoons. So basically they start blooming around summers and they bloom till late monsoon. It's a very drought tolerant plant and it can be grown in full sunlight only for its flowers. There is no need of fertilizer. They really don't need fertilizers. They can be easily grown without even fertilizing in any kind of soil, and so far I haven't seen any pest attack on them. Super easy to grow and care, and a highly recommended plant for those who are beginners in gardening. Let's talk about our next plant, which is Ixora. This is also called as jungle geranium or flame of woods. This plant is a bush variety and this comes in two varieties, the bigger one and the dwarf one. The one I'm holding is a dwarf size plant. This comes in many colors. The one I'm holding is a pink color flower. They come in yellow, red, pink and orange colors. They bloom in bunch and they look absolutely stunning. The most important characteristic of their flowers is once they bloom, they remain on the plant for more than 4 weeks. And they can be grown in full sunlight as well as in partial shade. I mean, they will produce flowers if they are grown in partial shade as well. Very easy to grow and maintain, and they can be easily grown from their stem cuttings as well. The next plant is rain lily or Zephyranthus lily. It's also called as fairy lily. As the name says, rain lily. They bloom profusely during rainy season or monsoons. They start blooming around early rainy season and they bloom till October. Once they bloom, they look absolutely amazing. They bloom, lots many flowers comes in one go. They come in many more colors like white, pink, orange color, shaded ones, red, many more colors they come. Very easy to grow in almost any kind of soil and very easy to grow from their bulb separation method, which is a root division method. If you want more flowers, put them somewhere it gets direct sunlight, and as and when it starts raining, they start blooming more and more. Super easy to grow with almost no care and maintenance plant, and highly recommended for those who love gardening but they haven't started yet. Our next plant is jasmine. They bloom in white color. I think almost everybody knows that during summers and monsoon season they bloom heavily with highly fragrant flowers. This plant loves direct sunlight for blooming. White color flowers that bloom in bunch, they look absolutely stunning, and during this season you'll see lots of new growth in the plant. There are two varieties in this plant. One is bush variety, one is creeper one, and they both flower in the same season, summer still rainy season. They can be grown from stem cuttings very easily. This plant grows really fast during this season, and if you want more flowers from this plant, prune them before the rainy season. Coming to our last plant, which is hibiscus, that comes in many colors. The hybrid ones, the regular ones, white, red, pink, yellow, you name the color and you'll find in the hibiscus plant. Very easy to grow from their stem cuttings, and the plant loves full sunlight for flowering. Prune your plant in early monsoon to get lots of flowers. Your plant will look more fuller and dense, as lots many new branches will come after pruning. And apart from this, a very common problem that we face during monsoon is pest attack in almost all the plants, be it indoor plant, outdoor plant or flowering plants. And when it comes to hibiscus, mealybugs are the most common pest attacks almost around the year. So to deal with them, take 5 ml of neem oil and a liter of water, add some liquid soap into it, mix it well, spray it all over the plant, under the leaf, on top of leaf, and this is the most effective and organic way to get rid of pest attacks. So these were few house plants that thrive during monsoon and bloom heavily during this season. In fact, I would say a must-have house plants for beginners in gardening, as they require almost no care and maintenance. Thank you for watching the video, and we are here for any further questions. Please email us at care@nurserylife.com. And don't forget to like, share the video and subscribe to Nursery Life channel to learn all about gardening. We would also love to hear from you when you create your garden. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook and tag us in all your pictures. Until then, keep on planting happiness.